Hello everyone, welcome to this session on deep dive on Ansible collections for network automation. My name is Ganesh Nalavade. I work as principal software engineer with the Ansible content engineering team. I am basically a software developer and I have around 13 years of experience doing so. I have worked extensively on the network management plane and have developed multiple software features for automation and programmability. I also maintain various on-box and out-box automation libraries. I am a co-organizer for Ansible Pune Meetup. So what will we be talking about in this session? So first we'll go through why and what of Ansible collections. Then we'll talk about Ansible network collections in specific. What are all the plugins that are part of Ansible collections for network use case. Then we'll go through how we can use an existing network collection. And then we'll talk about how you can create your own collections and what are things required to implement within the Ansible plugins for a network use case. And we'll go through a demo, small demo. So Ansible project for 2.9, it basically consisted of two main parts. One is Ansible base and other is Ansible content. Ansible base basically included things like Ansible engine, which is mainly responsible for loading the inventory files, passing the playbooks, and basically running the Ansible playbooks. And then Ansible content is mostly consisted of the Python files that the task that are written to the playbook. They basically map to a Python file which is called as Ansible module. Now apart from modules, there are various plugins like lookup plugin, filter plugin that falls into Ansible content content block. So combined this together, it formed Ansible project called as Ansible 2.9. So when you install an Ansible package, you would get both Ansible content and Ansible base as part of that package. So while this model worked well, but it over time, as the number of modules and plugins increased exponentially, it was not a scalable approach. So with Ansible 2.9, a typical workflow would be to create a module or a plugin, then test it, then deliver it with the result, with the Ansible release, and then consume it. So to go through this entire cycle, it would take around 3 to 6 months because it was a single monolithic package. And that's why the requirement of Ansible content and Ansible base was different. So Ansible base meant that over time it became stable and it would require less releases per year, whereas Ansible content, since users wanted to consume the content at a faster rate, they wanted to have this release at a much faster pace. So in 2.9, we move towards a deconstructed model wherein Ansible base along with a couple of modules and plugins required for bootstrap purpose formed the Ansible engine, and all the contents was moved into individual collections. So if I were to develop a content for Ansible, I would create it, test it locally, and deliver it using Ansible collections, and it would be consumed by users within days. So the outer cycle here represents a faster release cycle, and the inner circle here represents a slower release cycle. So Ansible base here is analogous to kernel, and the outer circle is analogous to various packages. So what is part of collections? Collections is basically a well-defined structure, and it follows a standard directory structure that basically mimics what was in the Ansible repository. It requires same documentation standard for Ansible project. And when you run, when you create an Ansible collection using Ansible Galaxy command, it scaffolds the directory structure for you. We'll look into more detail about plugins that are specific to network in later slides. Moving on, this is a top level view of directory structure of what Ansible collection is. So documentation docs folder contains the local documentation of collection. It is basically documentation for all the modules, all the plugins that are part of this collection. Then galaxy.yaml file, it contains the metadata for Ansible collection, like what version this collection is, if this collection is dependent on any other collection, or which all Ansible base version this collection works with. Then the playbook directory has the task folder, which provides playbooks for that are specific to this collection. So user can do include task from this collection in his own playbook and reuse this playbook. Plugins is where most of the logic goes. These are mainly Python files, and these plugins are basically what was there in part of Ansible plugin ecosystem. So modules are the Ansible modules, standard Ansible modules. Then module utils is where the common code for modules and other plugins goes. So other plugins like lookup plugin, filter plugin can also reuse the code that is part of module utils. Then lookup plugins, filter plugin, connection plugin are all the standard plugins that can be part of the collection. Then roles also can be part of collection. So collection is one level top of roles. And then you can have test, integration test, unit test for to test this collection. So moving on, where can we get this collection? So when someone creates a collection, he can upload that into Galaxy. It leverages the extended framework for collection. The Ansible Galaxy already is hosting roles, but starting 2.10, it has also started hosting collections as well. And all the latest and the greatest code is part of Ansible Galaxy. When you get access to Automation Hub, that is cloud.redhat.com, these collections are basically certified collections by Red Hat and partners. When you get access to this, you also get access to advanced analytics for this collection. And then it follows a slow and steady release process. So you can consider the collection that is part of Ansible Galaxy as an upstream. And the collection that is part of Ansible Automation Hub is the downstream collection. So moving on, I will go talk about specific about Ansible network collections. So previously, all the platforms platform code were part of a single package, that is Ansible in 2.9. But going forward in 2.10, we have segregated that into its into individual platform collections. So Cisco IOS has all the modules and plugins that are specific to the IOS platforms. Similarly for Cisco IOS, NXOS, Juniper JunOS, YOS. And these collections basically rely on Ansible Net Common Collection. So the Ansible Net Common Collection consists of common bits that are platform agnostic. It consists of the low-level connection plugins. So Cisco IOS basically uses a network CLI connection, which in turn uses an SSH to connect to device. So network CLI, NetConf, HTTP API, all these connection plugins are part of Ansible NetCommon. And since these plugins are independent of platform, it made sense to have this as a common collection and individual platform collections depending on this on a common Ansible NetCommon collection. So moving on, if I have to use an existing collection that is part of say Ansible Galaxy or Ansible Automation Hub, I can go ahead and install, run this Ansible Galaxy command. So Ansible Galaxy collection install cisco.ios. So Cisco here is the namespace and iOS is the name of the collection. So as you can see, a single namespace can have multiple collections. So Cisco here has is a namespace and it has multiple collections like iOS, ISXR, NXOS, so on and so forth. So once the collection is being installed, it by default goes into .ansible users home folder .ansible slash collections slash ansible underscore collections folder. So all the code is basically copied here when you run this command. And with this command, all the dependent collections are also installed. So since Cisco IOS has Ansible NetCommon collection as its dependency, it will install Ansible NetCommon collection as well. Now, if I have to use a platform agnostic module with this collection, this is a sample playbook that you can use. So host here is iOS. I have an iOS host entry in my inventory file. Then Ansible collection, it uses a fully qualified collection name. I have to provide a fully qualified collection name. here. So it basically tells that my network CLI connection is part of Ansible namespace and net common collection. Then the Ansible network OS, I have to set it to Cisco. Since I'm using a Cisco collection, I have to set it to cisco.ios.is. And then since I'm using a platform agnostic module, which is part of net common collection, so I have to give a fully qualified collection, a fully qualified module name. So CLI command is the name of the module, and it is part of net common collection. And command is the key that option that this module takes. And show version is a command that I have to run on the remote host, on the iOS host, and get the result of. Then there is a CLI config module, wherein I can execute config related commands. So if I have to use this platform agnostic module with network CLI collection type, I have to implement CLI conf and terminal plugins. We'll see more about this in the later slides. And if I have to use a module that is part of this collection, this is that example. So this basically executes the iOS interfaces module that is part of Cisco iOS collection. It basically takes the config, which is a list of interfaces and its parameters, name, description, enabled, and state here is merged. So this configuration will be merged onto the existing configuration onto the device. So again, the connection type I'm using here is network CLI, and the network OS value I have set it to cisco.ios.ios. So suppose if there is you don't have a collection for your platform and you want to develop that, you can very well do so. So to get started, we'll run this Ansible Galaxy command. This basically initializes the collection. And my org here, I have taken it as a namespace for sake of example. And NOS is the name of the collection here. So when I run this command, it basically creates this directory structure. It is a bare minimal directory structure. Now we can go ahead and add network specific plugins to this collections. So we'll talk about what are all the network specific collections here. So first is a terminal plugin. Terminal plugin is required if I have to use network CLI connection type. And this plugin basically has logic to control the terminal related parameters, like after immediately after creating a SSH session, what are things that needs to be done is being implemented in this terminal plugin. So things like privilege escalation, then setting the terminal bit, so on. So these are the this is the class that I have to implement in my terminal plugin. The terminal studio.re is basically a list of regex that tells me what are all the CLI prompt on the remote host. So this is used to identify end of an response after the command is executed. Then stdr, as the name suggests, is used to identify if there is a error in the response. If there is an error, the network CLI connection identifies that there is an error in the response, and then it signals the module that there was an error, and the error is being propagated to the user. Then on OpenShell is basically where the now logic is implemented, where things, actions that need to be taken when then shell is being opened. Then onbecome and onbecome are used for privilege escalation and de-escalation. Then the CLI config plugin is used again to implement the network CLI connection type. It basically abstracts the low level command execution with command execution calls with the connection plugin, and it exposes a set of API to be used with the module code. Then this is a sample code that this is a code that is being that should be implemented with the CLI conf plugin. So basically a CLI conf class, and it should inherited it should be inherited from the CLI conf base class. Then the methods that needs to be implemented are listed here. So get config is basically as the name suggests, running a command that fetches the current configuration from the remote host. So source here can you can control from which data store you want to get the configuration. It can be running candidate or startup data store. Then edit configuration basically moves the device into ensures that the device is in the config mode, and then runs the list of command that is being sent by the users from the module. Then getdiff basically gives the diff between the candidate and the running and the candidate data store to identify. This is mainly used to ensure the module learn is idempotent. So basically, if there is a difference, only then difference between the candidate and running config, only then the configuration will be applied, or else no action will be taken. Get here is used to run the operational mode commands. Then get device info. This method is used to get the device related information, like what version it is, what is the memory, storage. You can implement all this logic here. Then get capabilities is whether the device supports candidate data store, running data store, startup data store, whether it supports onboard diffs or not. So all this information is being implemented in the get capability. And run command is used to execute a list of commands. Then the next plugin type is netconf plugin. So this plugin needs to be implemented in the collection if you have to use netconf connection. So what goes into this plugin is basically the proprietary RPCs. So for example, Juno's platform supports certain proprietary RPCs, and those are being implemented in this plugin. And if I'm using this plugin, I have to set the Ansible Network OS value to the corresponding collection plugin. Suppose the remote device doesn't support any proprietary models and it supports all the standard RPCs, then in that case, you don't have to implement any specific plugin for this. You can just set to default, and it will take care of running all the standard RPC endpoints that is defined by the netconf RFC. To use this netconf connection, there are modules like netconf get, netconf config, and netconf RPCs that are part of that common collection. Then this moving on. So if in my collection I have to implement a netconf plugin and my platform supports some proprietary RPCs, those RPCs basically are implemented here. So load configuration, compare configuration, reboot are the some of the proprietary RPCs that are being supported by JunoS. So I just added here for sake of example. And the netconf base class is basically a part of Ansible, and it implements all the standard RPC endpoints. So these are this is the netconf base class. And as you can see here, all the standard RPCs are being implemented here. So this function basically uses NC client under the hood to send the XML RPCs and receive the response. So getconfig basically sends a getconfig XML RPC, creates an XML RPC, attaches the XML payload that is sent from the module side, and then it sends over to the device for execution. Then get basically runs the get RPC. It gets the operation and the configuration state of the information from the device. Then edit config is basically used to change the configuration. Validate is used to validate the syntax of the configuration. Then copy config is used to copy the running configuration from source to target. So source can be running and target can be candidate or startup, so on. Then lock is used to lock the target data store. Then unlock is used to unlock the data store. So basically, before doing any changes to configuration, these lock and unlock are used so that there is no redundancy. Then discard changes. If there is any changes that has gone to any data store, you can discard those changes by invoking this API. Then commit is used basically to commit the configuration from candidate to running data store. Get schema is used to get the Yank schema if the device supports it. Then delete config is used to delete a particular subset of a configuration or configuration from a particular data store. And get capabilities returns the server capabilities that are supported by the remote host. Then moving forward, then other type of plugin is HTTP API plugin, HTTP API plugin. So this plugin should be implemented if I have to use HTTP API connection for my collection. So this, if my remote host is supporting communication over HTTP API, I have to implement this plugin. Though this is not specific to network use case, it was implemented for network, but it can be used for other other verticals as well. With host that supports HTTP API protocol basically. And this plugin is basically, it takes in structured data and returns structured data as output. So these are the APIs that I have to implement for my plugin. So set become here sets the become context. It is mainly used for privilege escalation. Then login and logout are basically methods that logs that creates a session and logs out a session. Update auth is after a command is been executed and a response is received. After that, update auth method is been invoked. So this method tells basically for next command for next execution of the next command whether it should re-login or re-authenticate or not. And then handle HTTP error. Basically, all the errors that are received from the remote host are not errors. You can do some extra handling here. And after the handling, you can send the response to the module side of the code. And then the send request is the low-level API, which actually sends the HTTP data to the remote server and receives the response and returns to the module side of the code. So after I have implemented these plugins, this is how the directory structure of my collection would look like. So CLI conf folder would have this NOS plugin. Similarly for HTTP API netconf and terminal plugin. This, if I have to implement this collection to use all three types of the connections that I just mentioned. So after the connection is being written, I now have to build the collection. So building here, to build the collection, again, the Ansible Galaxy collection command is used, Ansible Galaxy collection build. This command, when executed in the topmost at the collection folder level, it creates a tarball at this location. So when this after this tarball is collection is created, I can install the collection using the Ansible Galaxy collection install command. I can, since the file is local here, I am giving the name of the tarball. And this command basically untars it, creates a dependency map, and then goes on to install the collection into this standard path by default. So after installing, if you have to use the content, you can go ahead. So this is a sample playbook. Host here is I want to talk to my NOS host. Then the, since I want to use network CLI connection, I will go ahead and mention the fully qualified connection name. So ansible.netcommon.networkcli. And since I'm using my own collection here, I have to set value accordingly. So myorg is the namespace, NOS is the name of the collection. And then NOS again is the name of the plugin that I'm using. Once I have this CLI conf and terminal plugin implemented, then I can use the CLI command module, that is a platform agnostic module, and execute command. And return that. So just by implementing CLI conf and CLI the terminal plugins, I can now use the platform agnostic module to go and manage the device. So moving on, everything is built out, you can publish this collection onto Galaxy. There is command to do that, Ansible Galaxy collection publish, the name of the tarball. Token here is the token that you will get from the Ansible Galaxy portal. And when you publish this collection, you have to ensure that the namespace is being created for in your account. So myorg here is the namespace, and if for this command to run, myorg should be present, the namespace should be present in the Ansible Galaxy. So let's move on to a demo here. I will show how a bare minimal collection would look like. So this is the directory structure, myorg. Myorg is the namespace, NOS is again the name of the collection. Inside the plugin folders, I have implemented a couple of plugins here for sake of this demo. The first one is the terminal plugin. So in the terminal plugin, There is this nos.py file. It has this std out, std error, regex list. Then on open shell, it is setting executing the terminal length, and it is setting the terminal length and terminal width, and then the privilege escalation and de-escalation on become related logic is implemented here. Then under the CLI conf, I have implemented a get, basic get command. It just receives the command from the module code and sends it over to the device. And this is how it is being used. So network OS is set to my OS, and I'm using the CLI command module that is part of net common collection. So when I run this, I will run with verbose mode so we can see what is happening under the hood here. So as you can see, the connection type set is network CLI. Then it goes and loads the CLI conf plugin that is part of my collection, and executes the show version, and it returns the command to the it returns the response to the module side and is displayed on the console. And suppose if I have to write my own custom module, after I have executed the command and received the response, and I have to add some logic on top of that, this is a sample. This is a module, that a bare minimum model that you can that I have written for sake of this demo. So a command is the input for this task, for this module command option. Then Ansible module creates Ansible module basically creates an object and does a lot of sets the values of this option and does a lot of background stuff here. And then to use the methods that are implemented in CLI conf plugin, I have to create an object of a connection class. And on this object, I invoke the get method. The get method is basically where the CLI conf plugin, the method that is implemented in the CLI conf plugin. And after getting after executing calling this API, I get this response and then pass it to as a result to the module code to the task. So if I have to run this the module, I'm using the my module here, my module task that is part of this collection, and command option is the parameter of this module, and I'm running this show interface command. So when I run this, it will go and fetch the show interfaces output and display it in the result. So this is the output. Output of the show interfaces. And as you can see, again, it is using the network CLI connection type from NetCommon. It loads the CLI conf plugin, and the module that is executed is the my module. So that's it from the demo side. So if you have any questions, I'll be available on the chat. And thank you for your time, and thank you for attending this session.